So welcome to the special edition of the Footie Show. I'm going to be speaking to the sports columnist Ian Hart and the Albion Raw blogger, who is Alan Wares, and we are going to be talking about the start of the season, the new Premier League season for the 21-22 season, which Brighton Hove Albion will be in. We're going to be talking about the COVID passports, whether they will be needed for some of the games. We're also going to be talking about the transfer market. Will Ben White be moving to Arsenal? Another transfer speculation. I know Alan has his own thoughts on the transfer speculation there. Plus, we're going to be talking about new Albion kits, and we're going to be talking about the first few games. We've got home games against Watford and Everton, plus an away game to kick off the season away to Burnley. So that's what we're going to be covering. Enjoy the show. So here with Ian Hart and Alan Wares for Albion Raw, and we've got Ian, sports columnist, and we're going to talk about this footy show, start of the season. Alan and Ian, 14th of August. Should we start off the transfer speculation? I know you have a few points to say about all the different transfer speculations going on.
Transfer speculation is just about the single most pointless thing that fills up your summer. It's even during a Euros or a World Cup, the commentators are going on and on about so-and-so linked with so-and-so linked with so-and-so. Stop it. It has no meaning. It's Take a Break magazine for the football fans. It's meaningless. It's Brazilian soaps for people who...
It's Gene Rook without the hairspray.
It's absolutely abysmal. It's just white noise.
Yeah.
So, who are we looking to sign then? Do you know?
Not really sure. I mean, it's been various people. Yeah. I mean, we can talk about Ben White leaving the Albion, because that seems fairly certain, or...
Well,
where are you putting that?
Certainly, that. I mean, he's probably having the longest medical in history.
It is. I mean, how many toes has he got that they need to look through?
How many times have they asked him to cough? This is what we want to know.
Yeah, he's been away on England duty during the summer, and it's brilliant we had a Brighton player doing so.
Yeah.
Good for them. And it's almost as if it's sort of a rumour that just won't go away. I mean, obviously, quite rightly, both the Albion and Arsenal are saying nothing on account of the fact it's extremely unprofessional to mention anything whilst conversations either are or aren't going on. So the tittle-tattle is almost certainly coming from, you know, either nosy journalists who are bored, or, you know, there's going to be an agent who has to let things slip. I mean, I'm reading stuff. At the time of recording this, he is having his, 17th medical?
Yeah,
something like that, yeah.
17th medical.
And it's imminent. It's
she
imminent.
Must be
it's
a nice imminent. Nurse doing it. That's all I
must be fantastic.
Because he's one for the ladies.
Ladies, yeah.
He's a ladies man.
Oh, he's a nurse's man. I can only assume he is Kenneth Williams.
Well, no, I think if Ben White is one thing, he's not Kenneth Williams. I think he's more Sid James. And but anyway, that's
sure
one for the
gonna
team.
I'm sure it's going to happen. Well, you know, I'm sure it's going to happen, but it's not going to happen in the time frame that the speculative journalists are talking about.
If we get that money, do you think then that alerts clubs that we've got money?
Well, I think every club realises that...
That we've all got money. Will that put prices up? What I'm trying to say, people that we're chasing now?
I think in the Premier League, no. I think if you're talking about a record sum, maybe. 50 million may or may not be considered too high for a rookie defender. It's his first year in the Premier League. A rookie defender.
The third best centre-back at the club.
Absolutely. Him too. And if he goes, we're going to have to work out who the third best defender is after that. But, you know, when every football club has its budget, and so 50 million is not necessarily a big budget for a Premier League club now. Does that mean we have an extra 50 million? Well, don't forget, assuming that 50 million is correct, the Albion aren't going to see all of that. They're going to see only a percentage of it. You've got VAT, you've got...
Agents
fees, you've got the sign-on fees, you're going to have... And this is working the assumption that the buying club's going to cough up in one hit.
Yeah.
So I would say, yeah, maybe one or two might be daft enough to think, oh, they've got an extra 50 million in the bank. The point is, we don't.
No. We never have done.
No.
This is we've always been paid on the never-never. It's always been, as it applies now, if you don't ask for a transfer, you get 10% of the transfer fee.
Right, OK. So that's 5 million locked off straight away. Yeah.
So then...
What about people coming in? I mean, there's been no movement at the moment. Has there any...
Well, we've got the computer.
Yes.
I'm looking forward to him. He looked good against against Rangers. I think that what we really are talking about is a striker.
Yeah.
Do we need a striker? Yeah. Now, I mean, I've said this on our show many times, is that... When Neil Maupay is on his game, and it is, we do have to zero in on him a little bit, when he's on his game, we know he can do it.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I always think of that last minute against Arsenal. There he was. Yeah. You know, he was hungry, he was sniffing for it, you know.
I'm a Maupay fan.
Yeah.
I'm a Maupay fan, and I think he's had a lot of unnecessary stick. Yes, before everybody says, well, you've slagged players off in the past. Yes, I have slagged players off in the past. We all do. That's what football fans do. Yeah, Farrington and, you know, others. Andy Kennedy.
Yeah.
But what I am saying
at
is...
At the same time we had them.
Michael Mahoney-Johnson. The list is endless. Who was that one that... Lorenzo Pinamonte.
Instead of Zamora.
Yeah, from Brentford. We even had a song about him. That's how good he was. Anyway... I'm a Maupay fan, so I don't want him to go.
Yeah.
I would like to see us getting a striker in, and this is something that I know that Alan and I have spoken about when he very kindly had me on the Albion Raw. We are going to have to break that threshold of paying someone $100,000 a year if you're going to get someone who's tried and tested.
I think most of the players are on $100,000 a year, mate.
No, they're not.
$100,000 a week?
Oh, yeah.
Very good.
$100,000 a week.
Yeah.
Sorry.
I'm not even sure that actually paying someone that amount is that... I mean, when you talk about footballers' salaries, and we're back to what we talked about on a recent show, we're talking about sort of, I wouldn't take this amount of money for the abuse you get. And we're back to the Euros and the appalling racist abuse... suffered by certain England players. And the appalling racist abuse that's meted out by, frankly, places that should know better. And the response comes back, yeah, but they're on such great wages for that. No, there is no salary that can actually account for that.
I could not agree more with you. I do think that we do, and rightly so in some ways, focus on racist abuse, but I would like you should stretch that out to all abuse.
Yes.
I have to hold my hands up. I've got a daughter who's been in the public eye. Some of the abuse that my daughter gets, some of the abuse that her friends get, and you know, other people, and she knows that Bobby Norris from Towie, and he's trying to bring in Bobby's Law.
Yeah,
which is about trolling, and you know, and Gemma Collins. Some of the things she gets. So it's all general, but it should be general. Yeah. It should be abuse.
Yes.
But you are right. That racist abuse, you couldn't pay someone.
There isn't a salary to cope
money
for it. Yeah.
For them to be called, well, we can't say what they're being called.
Well, I think we understand what's being said, and there is there's nothing to account for it. So I'm getting back to your original point of saying that. Paying someone $100,000 a week, yes, you're more likely to have a decent striker for that, but you know, I think that the club will actually see to run itself as a business first and foremost, rather than, and if it means us only getting to climbing to 12th next season rather than leaping all the way up to 7th, then I think they'll do it in increments. They'll do it when they can afford it.
Yeah. What about start the season then? Adam, what's the first few games? We've got Burnley away, and then we've got Watford and Everton at home.
Just curious as to what 11 is going to put out on the first thing, because I think there's some players who are, not to say they're not going to be eligible, but I think we've got some at the Olympics.
Olympics, yeah.
So they're not going to be eligible. We're getting mixed messages a little bit, I think, about the fitness, the relative fitness of certain players. But I think...
That's all speculation.
Isn't it? Just, yeah. Well, we get one story from one person, another story from another person. You think, well, OK, let's hear it from Graham Potter. He is the ultimate, the definitive sort of person to say it. But I also want to put out there that if, and it is a big if, still at the time of recording, that we do lose Ben White, that the Albion does have at least a reasonable recent history of bringing on decent centre-backs, and we've got another one who's looking to make his breakthrough. And I've seen him play as a junior a few times, and Ostergaard, I think, could make that step up. Yeah. He has it within him. So given that the defence is actually quite important...
What about this Clark, though, that we signed from Portsmouth and we loaned him out to Derby?
I think he has now gone to West Brom.
He's gone to West Brom full-time. So
It's just one of those things.
What was that deal all about? It's just a waste of time.
There's been a few of those, haven't there?
I think it was covering our backside in case Ben White didn't come out. You know, so if Ben White... Hang on. No. All right.
Let's do that again. 3-2-1.
I think what the club's doing is just covering itself, just in case Ben White didn't make the leaps and bounds that he ended up doing. So, it's not as though I think it cost the Albion a fortune for Matt Clark to be with us. You know, Derby and wherever it was, Portsmouth. We got him from Portsmouth, didn't we? Mm. So, and he's made a step up, but just to the Championship for the time being.
So that's it for the first half. Join me for the second half.
Remember, you can keep in touch with us on the various social media channels, Twitter and Facebook, by searching Latest TV. Plus, of course, you can see all our clips and get the latest news at our website, which is www.thelatest.co.uk. We'll see you in just a few minutes.
So welcome back to this special edition of the Footie Show. I'm joined by Adam Wares, who is the blogger for Albion Raw, and also the sports columnist Ian Hart. We're going to be discussing vaccination passports at the Amex Stadium. Will they be used, and how's that going to work in practice? Seems to me that everything's going to be on the iPhone now. So we've got the season ticket, we've got payments all done via the iPhone, and now the vaccination passports are a possibility. So that's going to be a talking point. Plus, we're going to look at Albion's new kit, and we're going to be also discussing the first few fixtures away to Burnley and at home to Watford and Everton. So join us for the second half. I had to see the first few games going, and I know we're going to do a proper preview, Ian, but... not too bad, Burnley away. It's quite a tricky game, though, isn't it?
As we've got people at the Olympics. We're buying him. Are we selling him? Are we doing this? Are we doing that? Harold Wilson said a week in politics is a long time. A week in football is
a lifetime.
Is an eon. So I don't think, you know, we'll really know. I mean, don't forget, in 2000, we didn't sign Bobby Zamora until the Friday afternoon.
It was something like that,
And then we went to Southend. Lost 2-0.
With the Albion fans singing Bring on the Champions.
Kuiper's got hooked at half-time.
Yep, and David Lee turned us over.
Yeah, and my friend Gary Cyphers, one of Worthing's hard-working taxi drivers on the rank, ran on the pitch and got banned.
And we had Crispies climbing the stanchion.
But he scored... to be fair, Gary Cyphers scored that day, which is more than the Albion did. But no, we won't know. We won't know, and you know, this time next week, when we're recording next week's show, we might have made two or three signings. I mean, it's gone very quiet on the Bissouma front.
It has. I was going to mention Bissouma.
To be honest, I mean, and we when I do the Albion Raw, we're also invited onto other clubs' podcasts as well. And one that I'm a semi-regular on is the Anfield Wrap, and that's very, very well listened to across the world. And I know that the Liverpool fans are very, very impressed by Yves Bissouma when they've seen him play. And I said, look, you know, I'm sure he could make the step up to Liverpool, and if you did want him, then he'd do it. But I did say to them, I think he would be something really good for you, but not yet. I actually feel the same about Ben White. Now, if Arsenal want to pay silly money for him now, even as we're recording, I'm going to look stupid about this if this goes through this afternoon. I'm still not convinced Ben White's going, you know.
You see, I thought we had to sell Bissouma now because he was it's like an avocado.
Go on.
It ripens just at the right time, but only for a short time.
I know.
And I thought Bissouma was our avocado, as Lawrenson was in the summer of 1981.
Yeah.
We have to sell them at the optimum time.
I guess so, but I don't think that Bissouma is still the final finished product yet. I think another season of Bissouma will actually then make him irresistible to other clubs.
Yeah, COVID-19 passports then on the app. That might be coming in for the Premier League games.
COVID-19 passports will come everywhere.
Yeah.
There's obviously an issue with under-18s.
Yeah.
Because they haven't been given them all yet. I think it's just going to be a natural... I think everyone will have to show some form to say they've been double jabbed.
Yeah.
As I bizarrely was at the semi-final and the final.
Were you?
With people coming flying over the top of me. And, you know, I don't think everybody was asked at the semi-final and the final of the Euros. No. But, you know, that it is what it is, so...
Yeah. What do you think of that, Adam? Because, I mean, to get in now, you're going to use the app to pay. You use it to, obviously, to get in, to a season ticket.
It's called progress.
Yeah,
I've got to be honest with you, though. I can see the point of a COVID passport. I'm not 100% sure of the arguments against it, unless people are thinking it unfair. I think if there was going to be something like this, it should only be available once everyone has had the opportunity to have had a double jab, and not everyone. A lot of people have had a single jab by the time that, because the legislation is supposed to be that it's going to be for nightclubs from the end of September.
Yeah.
Why not now? No idea, but from the end of September. Which means that certainly football won't be bringing it in before the end of September, which means that you're going to have this ridiculous sort of admin that every club's going to have to sort out. It's going to be a mess on the ground. Whether it's morally right or not is another matter entirely, but if it is going to be offered. Morals in society generally, Ian, we have to live by them. We do our best, but
they're great bedfellows, aren't they?
Yes, only at the time when everyone has been offered a double jab or, you know, has been eligible for a double. And before that, I don't think there's a level of fairness about it. As to those who are against being jabbed anyway, we're not allowed to swear on here.
Yeah, exactly. Before we finish up, full crowds then from the 21st of August. Home against Watford, that's going to make a big difference. We were lucky enough to be at those games.
Great.
Without crowds, it's going to make a big difference.
Superb crowds coming back, getting everybody back interested. I don't know what the season ticket take-up has been.
I was going to ask you about that. I don't know
what it is. What I do know is that a number of people in 1901 East have given their seats up.
Yeah.
And I do know a couple of people that have, well, a few people that have given up their season tickets elsewhere in the ground. But we will know, and we did have this, was it 8,000 waiting list? So everybody on the waiting list has almost certainly been accommodated, or a vast number have. So it'll all be good.
Yeah.
Just get there. I think it's 5:30 kickoff because we're live on Sky.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
So I'll have to take casualty that night, but that's fine, you know.
Matches in August, they're often sort of, you're not say sparsely attended, but they're not as fully attended as games through autumn and winter, just because people have been traditionally on holiday.
Yeah.
And even whether they're on holiday abroad this year or on holiday in the UK, they'll still be away. So, you know, don't expect don't forget, it's a new capacity, 32,500.
Yeah.
That is the legal capacity of the Amex now. So, but don't expect a crowd that size. But if you do remember back to the Manchester City game, and there was, 8,000 in the crowd that day, we are talking about an enormous sense of relief that any crowd was back in there. The fact that we then turned the champions over, if we can recreate that kind of atmosphere week in, week out, then, you know, it gives the players every incentive, every boost, and those fine lines that we were so missing last season, maybe we can cross them this season.
Yeah, exactly. Just before we finish up, the new kit, do you like it? Is it a winner for you?
It's a kit.
Blue and white stripes. That's who we are.
Blue and white stripes. That's what we are. All the kids will buy it, which is good for the club.
Mm-hmm.
It's lovely to drive around Worthing, and I'm sure you do it in Brighton. But it's nice to drive round and see kids wearing Albion shirts rather than Manchester United shirts, Manchester City shirts, Arsenal, Spurs, Liverpool, whoever, Chelsea. Let's see all the kids. Support your local team.
Yeah.
But thank God I'm not a parent of a kid that wants a kit every season, because it's not cheap.
It's not cheap.
And
okay.
I've got that when my grandchildren come. So
brilliant.
Hurry up, Sam and Amy.
Yeah, we'll leave it there. Alan, Ian, all the best, and we'll catch up again soon. Thanks.
Thank you.
So that's it. That's the Footie show with Ian Hart and with Alan Wares. And we're going to be having a regular show with Alan and Ian for the new season. So join us then for the start of the 21-22 Premier League season featuring Brighton Hove Albion. Looking forward to the new fixtures as well as the new kit. So join us for our regular weekly show, the Footie show on Latest TV.
Remember, you can keep in touch with us on the various social media channels, Twitter and Facebook, by searching Latest TV. Plus, of course, you can see all our clips and get the latest news at our website, which is www.thelatest.co.uk. We'll see you in just a few minutes.